Greetings everyone, I am Akanksha. Today I will be presenting the topic Production Technology of Apples. But before commencing, I would like to thank our course instructor, Dr. Prashant Bakshi, who emboldened us to learn through such an innovative way. The contents of our presentation are entailed as follows, starting with the introduction. The cultivated apple, Malus domestica, belongs to the family Rosaceae or Pomodi. Apple is a false fruit, that is, it arises through thalamus, not by ovary, thus falling into the category of pom fruit. Apple is a diploid and has 34 chromosomes in total. The health benefits and nutritional value of apple is given as follows. Now coming on to the botanical description. Plant. Plant is small to medium sized tree with spreading canopy to 30 feet in wild and 6 to 15 feet in cultivation. Leaves are elliptical with serrate margins, dark green with light pubescence on the underside. Flowers. Petal can white when open but have red pink undersides when opening. The ovary is inferior, embedded into the floral cup or hypanthium, containing 5 locules, usually 2 ovules per locule. The inflorescence is a cyme of 4 to 6 flowers. Flowers are produced terminally from mixed buds on spurs or to a lesser extent on longer shoots. Pollination. Most cultivars are commercially self-unfruitful. Fruit. A special fruit is a given to type of related fruits, the pome. The bulk of the fleshy edible portion derives from hypanthium or floral cup, not the ovary. Seeds are relatively small and black and mildly poisonous. Fruits begins 3 to 5 years after budding, although few fruits may be produced in the second year. Pollination. Most cultivars are commercially self-unfruitful. Blossom compatibility is rare. Most cultivars that bloom at the same time are not spores of each other and will serve as pollinizers, including the crab apples. Single apple tree produces some fruit, while some self-pollinated, because cultivars are not totally self-incompatible. A few cultivars that are pollen sterile are Jonah Gold, Vine Sap, and Mutsu. Honeybees are the most effective pollinators. Pollinizer plant is recommended in India is 11 to 30%. Pollinizer plant are Royal Delicious variety, plantation of Dead Delicious and Golden Delicious as pollinated is also recommended. The pollination scheme is given in the figure. Inadequate fruit set often results from failure during the pollination period, which is associated with pollen production, transfer, germination, pollen tube development. Low temperature, rainfall and cloudiness also affect the pollination. Although in the world, the cross-pollination in apple can be improved by planting at least 25-33% pollinizer, while in India, 11-30% is recommended. Placement of bouquets is also recommended. Flowering and fruit set. Apples start bearing at the age of 4-6 years. Pear type varieties start bearing early date than the standard bearers. Similarly, cyan cultivars start bearing earlier if grafted on a dwarfing rootstock than on a seedling rootstock. Apple bears terminally on spurs. Flower bud differentiation takes place in July and flowering in spring. Now, flowering and characterization of early flowering. The initiation of flower primordia starts about 3-6 weeks after full bloom, that is in June. Inflorescence is determinate, having 5 flowers. Flowers of most cultivar are epigynous and hermaphrodite. Induction of early flowering includes some practices that are commonly used. For branches, bending of branches of young trees at an angle of 45 degrees from the main trunk help in early flowering. Nutrient control, trees should get sufficient nitrogen that could not inhibit the flower formation. Nutrients like zinc, copper and are determinable. When there is tilling deficiency, the bud break will be poor. For bud break, application of sandolin, dinitroorthocysol at 0.5% and 2% in mineral oil emulsion during January is recommended. Now, talking for the climate, the temperate crop with temperature requirement of 21 to 24 degrees Celsius. For fruit setting, it is 21.1 to 26.7 degrees Celsius. Chilling up includes below 280.15 Kelvin for at least 1000 to 1600 hours. Although areas with spring frost must be avoided, rainfall should range anywhere between 25 to 175 cm per hour. Under subtropical zone at an altitude of 1600 to 2500 meters above mean sea level, also apple can be grown. Next is soil. Soil preference is loamy, well-drained with rich organic matter with a light clay subsoil. pH includes 5.5 to 6.5. Soil with a good depth of 45 cm is preferable. For planting, bed size should be 1 meter in length, breadth and depth. Planting system required is square or hexagonal system. Planting time is between January to February. The average number of plants in an area of 1 hectare can range between 200 to 1250. For different type of categories, different planting densities are written. For example, in low, 250 plants per hectare is used. For moderate, 250 to 500 plants per hectare is used. For high, 500 to 1250 plants are used, and for ultra high density, more than 1250 plants per hectare is used. Note that during planting, 30 to 40 kg of of FYM, 500 grams of SSP and 50 grams of malathion dust are added, mixing properly in each bit. For high density planting in apple, with advent of spurt cultivars and vigor controlling rootstocks, the system of planting has become popular, especially in case of apple. It produces a higher yield and higher returns per unit area. The various types of high density planting in apple include semi-intensive, that includes 500 to 1000 trees per hectare, intensive 1000 to 10000 trees per hectare, and super intensive 10000 to 100000 trees per hectare. For the sake of propagation, apple varieties are propagated through tongue and whip method of grafting. Rootstocks are either related species such as Malus sylvestris, Malus prunifolia, and Malus chimiensis, or their hybrid derivatives or seeding progenies of cultivated varieties are used. Propagation of rootstocks can be done either by clonal rootstocks or by seedling rootstocks. Clonal rootstocks are not recommended in India. For propagation of scion, tongue grafting and chip budding is used. Characteristics of an ideal rootstocks include: it should have a successful union with scion cultivar. It should provide good anchorage to the tree. It should be easily propagated. It should be easily available. It should be dwarf enough to control tree size of the scion cultivar. It should have ability to grow in a variety of soils. It should be resistant to biotic and abiotic stresses. The practices used on apple trees are as follows. The first one is training. Training helps to establish a strong framework of scaffold limbs capable of supporting heavy yield with the quality of fruits, regulate annual succession of crops, exposure of maximum leaf surface area to the sun, direct the growth of trees so that various cultural operations can be held out easily. The plants are trained according to the growth habit and the vigor of rootstocks. The standard trees are trained on modified central reel system, and spindle bush system is suitable for dwarf plants in high density planting under mid-hill sec conditions. The both of them are shown in the figures. The next one is pruning. Pruning is essential to maintain a proper balance between vegetative growth and spur development. Proper pruning of weak and undesirable branches, twigs, necessarily is included after every 6 years of plantation. The center should be kept for a better fruit color and development. The next one is fruit thinning. Heavy bearing apples during an year results in small size and poor quality fruits. Therefore, judicious thinning and proper stages of fruit development is must to regulate cropping and improving the size. But hand thinning is very laborious, so foliar spray of naphthalene acetic acid is used as pre-petal fall. Next one is ringing and scoring. Scoring and ringing are performed 1 or 2 weeks after full bloom using a sharp knife. This practice may, however, include blossom bud formation during the year of treatment, but can cause some trees to show severe shock symptoms. Now coming on to the manures and fertilizers. The manure and fertilizer requirement depend upon the soil fertility, age of tree, cultural practices, and crop load. Up to the age of 10 years, the ratio used is 70:35:70 gram per year per tree of NPK. For above 10 years, 100 kg of FYM, 700 gram of nitrogen, 350 grams of phosphorus, and 700 gram of potassium should be given annually. FYM along with full doses of P2O5 and K2O is applied during December and January. Although nitrogen is given in split doses, an area with high rainfall with leaching problems should be given water-soluble fertilizers. Now the role of plant growth developers or plant growth regulators are as follows. For propagation, gibberellic acid 3 at the rate of 100 to 200 ppm, indole butyric acid at the rate of 2000 ppm, and naphthalene acetic acid at the rate of 200 ppm is given. For growth mediation purposes, PP333 at the rate of 500 to 1000 ppm, gibberellic acid 3 at the rate of 250 ppm, and for the fruit drop purposes, naphthalic acid at foliar spray is given at 10 ppm concentration. Now coming on to the practice of irrigation. The most critical periods of water requirement is April to July, when the flowering, food set, and fruit growth development occurs. The rainwater should be harvested and collected in water storage tanks and used for irrigation, particularly during critical periods of water requirement. Drip irrigation method saves more water than 50%, and irrigation water is adopted in water scarce areas. For the purpose of weeding, clean basin management system is used. The basins of trees are kept clean and free from weeds. Gamaxone or paraquat is applied at 0.5%, or glyphosate at the rate of 100 milliliter per hectare is used as post-emergent herbicide, suppressing the weed growth for about 4 to 5 months. About 6 to 8 irrigation at 7 to 10 days interval should be given between April to July and apple. Now coming on to mulching and intercropping. In bearing orchard, mulching of basin area of trees with 10 cm thick layers of hay or black alkathene is used. Short grasses like white clover, red clover, orchid grasses and rye are used. In initial years of plantation, the intercrops like peas, beans, cabbage, cauliflower and ginger are used. Green manuring crops like bean, peas and gram are recommended. In harvesting and yield, we know that fully mature trees, when start developing color, can be harvested. The normal yield ranges from 100 to 150 tons per hectare in medium density planting. Maturity. Days from full bloom is relatively constant from year to year and gives growers a rough estimate of picking date. Cultivars like Gala mature early and Fuji mature very late. Also, there are few maturity indices which helps farmer to take an estimate when the fruit is going to mature. Harvest method. Apples must be hand-picked to avoid bruising and reduction of fresh market quality grade. Fruit must be picked carefully to avoid damaging the spur while next season's fruit will be born. Note that here, a robotic arm for picking or a machine for picking can be used, but that is an international technology yet to come in India. Now, post-harvesting handling. Packaging. Standard packaging liner plates are used for apple after harvest. Hydrocooling, washing, culling, waxing, sorting and packaging are done. Apples are packed most often in 4 to 5 bushel boxes that are of 40 pounds, but polythene bags that could be 5 to 10 pounds are used. Storage. The storage room atmosphere is altered to retard respiration by reducing oxygen to 2 to 3%, raising carbon dioxide to about 1%. That is to ensure that ethylene production is low, as apple is a climatic fruit. The flow chart that explains post-harvest handling much better is given here. Coming on to the next topic, that is fruit drop. Apples bloom profusely, but a small percentage of flower will mature into fruit. Most of the flowers fall soon after full bloom, with a small amount of dropping late. To prevent that, AVG or aminoethoxyl vinyl glycine at the rate of 200 ppm is sprayed, which can increase the fruit set to 10 folds when applied between pink and petal fall. In most of the commercial varieties, 40 to 60% of fruit drops occur in the following times, that is early drop, June drop and pre-harvest drop. Now coming on to the next important aspect of plant production technology, it is plant protection. Plant protection against pests. First one is aphid-positive organism being Aerosoma lanigerum and aphid spomae. The symptom includes they feed on new wood and roots to form galls. Cold and wet conditions favor the development of this pest. Management includes destruction of eggs before hatching should be done by spraying tar oil or DNOC petroleum oil through wetting the bark of the tree, spraying of organophosphates insecticides that could be malathion 0.2%, phosphomidone 0.2% or anything else at green clustered stage will be effective. For the case of woolly aphids, that the causative organism being Aerosoma metanae use resistant rootstock like nursery spy robusta 5. Its main natural enemy are parasitoids and Aphelaneous mali, which are an important control agent. The next pest being red spider mites. The causative organism are Panoccius ulmi. Symptoms includes the mites suck up sap from the trees, which may turn bronze in color. In severe infestation, the growth of plant is markedly reduced. The management includes the component of integrated management of red spider is regulation of predators that are Typhlodomus pyrae and Embyalysis andrinsoni. Now, coming on to some common diseases found in apple trees. First one is apple scab. The causative organism is Venturia inequalis. Symptom includes velvety brown to olive green powdery lesions, which turn mousy black with age, appear on leaves and lead to premature yellowing of leaves, defoliation and fruit drop. Next one is San Jose scale, caused by Quadricepidus pernicious. Symptoms of damage include infested region of bark becomes reddish pink purple discoloration and on fruits purple discoloration spots are found. For management, some are spray of phosphalone 50 EC or 0.5% or phenytoathione at 50 EC 0.5% is sprayed. For winter spray, diesel oil emulsion at 8 to 12 liters per tree is used. Next one being powdery mildew. The causative organism is Podosphaera leucotrica. Symptoms are whitish powdery growth develops on both sides of leaves and twigs. The affected leaves are distorted in shape and smaller in size, becomes hard and brittle. Management includes destruction of overwintering fungus structures, reduction of inoculum by pruning the shoots. Spraying trimethaphon at 0.05% or pyrazophus at 0.021% is recommended. The next one are the important varieties of apples that are grown in India. Apple is a temperate fruit, thus grown in temperate regions in India and Himachal Pradesh. Varieties like King of Pippins, McIntosh, Golden Delicious, Red Gold, Starking Delicious, Lello Newton and Granny Smith are grown. Note that Red Gold, Red Delicious, Golden Delicious and Granny Smith are also internationally acclaimed varieties. In Jammu and Kashmir, Irish Peach, Cox Orange, Pippin, Kiri Pippin, Umbri, Lal Cider, Golden Delicious, Red Delicious, Sunehri and Raza Khwar are important varieties under cultivation. In case of Uttar Pradesh, Fanny, Cortland, Early Shanbury, Golden Delicious, McIntosh, Red Delicious, Buckingham are important varieties. In the hills of tropical region where warm weather conditions exist, Palin's Beauty, Tropical Beauty have been judged as second best and best performers respectively. They require only less chilling, bud breaking and flowering. Some important varieties are shown in the pictures. Now, some questions relating to the production technology of apple are given below. Question number 1. Botanically, apple fruit is in the category of, and the options are cirrhosis, drupe, pome and berry. The answer is pome. Second question is, inflorescence in apple is, options are cyme, cyathium, umbel and corymb. The answer is cyme. Third question, ploidy level of Malus domestica is, and the options are polyploid, haploid, tetraploid and diploid. The answer is diploid. Fourth question is, the chemical used for degreening in the fruit is, options are gibberellic acids, cytokinins, ethylene or indole butyric acid. The answer is ethylene. Fifth question is, apple bowl of India is, the options are J&K, Himachal Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh or none of the above. The answer is Himachal Pradesh. The sixth question is, which of the following is the king of temperate fruits? The options are pear, peach, plum and apple. The answer is apple. Now the next question is, the ultra raw fruit stock of apple is, the options are M27, M9, MM106 and none. The answer is M27. Next question is, which element is low in apples? The option is phosphorus, sodium, manganese and copper. The answer is sodium. The references for this particular presentation are given as follows. At the end, I would like to thank everyone.